Hello, my friends. Thanks for stopping by. I am naked again today. I did get a couple of new things and I thought I would just go ahead and demonstrate them, give you a first impressions on them. And I had worn this actually in my last video, my Anastasia eyeshadow video, and I'm not really sure how I feel about it yet. I may be on the fence of not caring for it, but we're going to give it another try. I am going to use my beauty blender to apply it. It is the Natasha Denona Face Glow Primer. Now, she does have different primers for your skin type. Mine is the hydrating because, you know, I am dry as a prune. And then I got the Natasha Denona Face Glow Foundation SPF 15. Now, I know there's a whole system that goes with this, but I will be honest with you, even though I am an aging woman, I don't want glow all over my face. I feel greasy then. And I'm not sure how the whole system would work for me as far as my preference of look on the face. I like a glow on my face, but not at all in my T-zone area. And usually not for my eyelids because I think I just begin to look oily then. So let's go ahead and try this on camera and I will tell you what I feel. The cream, you can get these at Beautylish and I'm not sure if you can buy them right off of their site. It is a thick white cream. So I'm just going to take some of it on my hands because that's how she shows doing it in a video. So we're going to just massage that in. Now, when I use a primer, I'm using a primer to address my pores that have gotten larger in my T-zone area. And that is the main reason I'm using a primer on my skin. Not necessarily to get a glow. And one thing about wearing glow on your face, you can't just stop dead and have a matte neck and chest. You have to incorporate it a little bit. So that is the primer. It feels nice on the skin. It is a little tacky right now, but that's true for any primer that you're using. They need a moment to set. All right, so I got the foundation in 42. I'm not sure that this is the right color for me. I did order it from Beautylish. I've never returned anything to Beautylish. I don't know if they're good or bad about it, but I'm not sure this is the perfect color for me. But again, it's hard to tell online, and this product I can't go and touchy-feely anywhere else. So I'm just going to take, it comes in a pump tube. I'm just going to take two pumps of the product. And I'm going to go ahead and apply it with my beauty blender. So I'm just going to take some of the primer. It feels very rich, thick, and creamy. A little bit more than a tinted moisturizer. Okay, so let's just go ahead and put this on all the places I normally would. And then I'm just going to wipe the excess off with my beauty blender. And I'm going to go ahead and pounce over my face. You can use your hands with this. You could use a makeup brush. They show her applying it with a makeup brush. I did not like the application of a makeup brush with it, so I am going to stick with what I felt looked the best. The color turns out to be, it's okay. It gets a little, it oxidizes just slightly on me. And as I've mentioned in many videos before, I do have a problem with some foundations oxidizing on me. I have better luck with higher end foundations than I do with drugstore, although I have found a couple of drugstores that don't oxidize. This one doesn't get necessarily orange, it just darkens slightly on my skin. So that is one application of this. As you can see, let me go up underneath my eyes to let you know. You all know that I struggle with darkness around my eyes, and usually I can go ahead and put foundation up under there and it helps a little bit. I'm going to go right over my eyelids. You can see that this really doesn't address it totally, so I will have to wear concealer with it. Anyway, I will tell you what my feeling on this foundation is, and this may seem really silly to some of you, but for me it is important. This feels uncomfortable on my skin. It never really gets to that settled feeling for me. It always feels like I have a layer of something on my skin. I don't care for that. And it has a tackiness to it. There is no way that I could go ahead and apply a powder blush over this without it catching. So you do have to wear a powder, which then defeats the purpose of the glow. So you have to make sure that your powder has a little bit of a glow. And I did go ahead and get the La Mer translucent powder. So many of you told me you loved it. And I also got some concealers because so many of you told me you love these. So I thought, okay, because this concealer I feel is ridiculous in price. But I went ahead and I got it just to try it out because so many of you say it's fabulous. And so many of you talk about the translucent La Mer powder. And then I saw Lisa talking about it. I had ordered it a long time ago and then just automatically sent it back because I thought, I don't really care for La Mer. But anyway, I went ahead and got it because so many of you said you loved it. So this is the glow you get. It is a beautiful glow. Like I said, there's just something about it that doesn't settle on my skin nicely. But it always stays tacky for me. All right, so now I'm going to just do one more layer of it because you can still see some imperfections. I'm having a little bit of issue with my hives. I have them all, if you see my hand, I'm all hived out, and it's just another day in hive paradise. But anyway, I'm just going to put a little bit more. So I'm going to do a dot on each side of the cheeks, forehead, T-zone, chin. And then again, I'm just going to wipe the excess onto my Beauty Blender. And I'm going to go ahead and blend a second layer because it says you can build it to be a more coverage foundation, which I know is very important to many because not everybody has flawless skin. So we want to make sure that we can play with this. So that's what we shall do. But you see, you do have to keep your neck in mind when you're using this because you don't really want to have the J-Lo glow face and not neck. So just run it slightly down. I wouldn't put as much on my neck as I would on my face. Okay. So there we have it, just all pounced down nicely. And you cannot deny the glow that you get. There is a beautiful, beautiful glow, but you have to set it with powder because it just is really a tacky feel. All right, so you're all wondering, what is this concealer that they are all talking about? And I ended up ordering two colors because I wasn't sure which one was going to work for me. And this is the By Terry Densilis Concealer. I went ahead and I got two colors. I got 2 and 3, vanilla beige and natural beige. I'm going to go ahead and try the natural beige because I think it probably will work best for me. It looked like it had just a little bit more color to it. Comes in a beautiful tube. It is $60-something dollars. Ridiculous. Ridiculous. I've not tried it. I don't know how it's going to work. So we're just going to go ahead and I can tell you right now this color is going to be too light for underneath my eyes. So we will have to see because you have to be very careful when you're using concealer as an aging woman or anybody else for that matter. All this highlighting going on is a beautiful thing, but sometimes we can look a little raccoonish. So I'm going to go ahead and blend this with my Beauty Blender because it'll blend down better for me. I'll do one side with the Beauty Blender and then one with my other hand. Now, I do have many fine lines, and as you know, I have darkness. Okay, so let's try the other side just by patting it in with my finger. I also like using the Marc Jacobs concealer brush with my concealers. Okay, so it is a very lightweight concealer. In the camera, to me right now, it is looking like it has covered my dark circles, but when I look in the mirror, I can see them. But I'm going to leave it like this, and we're just going to go ahead and do the powder now. I can't tell you, it's a very lightweight, at first impression, it seems very nice, my friends. So some of you were very nice. But let's see how it looks after I go ahead and powder now the whole foundation as well. Again, I got the Le Mer, and you know, so many of you just go on about this powder that it is just divine. So I thought I have to be a part of all this divineness. So let me go ahead and put some of this, let's see, get some of this powder out. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right, now I'm going to go ahead and use my, I don't know, this is almost like a sin using this cheap brush with this expensive powder, but I'm going to go ahead and do it. All right, so I'm just going to take some of the powder, put it in. I'm going to touch it off a little bit because I'm not sure how it's going to play. And I'm going to go ahead and just tap it on my face because I don't really want to disturb the glow. I just want to set this foundation. Let's do my T-zone area first because that's the part I don't like glowing. There's no way I could have put a blush unless I was using a cream blush over. Then I could have easily done it, but I don't wear cream blushes. Not yet. I just don't wear them. I have a couple and I just don't care for them. I prefer a powder. I'm an old dog. Sometimes I can't be taught new tricks and I don't want to learn the new trick. Okay, so I think the powder is beautiful. So now I need to take just a little bit of the powder and I want to put it underneath my eyes. But I'm going to take my E8 Morphe brush and I'm just going to put a little bit of this powder on here. I'm going to tap to make sure I have no lines and then I'm just going to pull it just slightly so that the lines all disappear. And we'll do the same thing on the other eye. And then I will take a look-see. From a distance, it all looks fabulous. The glow is still there. It's peeking through the powder. This may make me keep the Natasha Denona. That powder, I must say, you were all very right about it. It is, there's nothing cakey about it. It is just beautiful. I'm putting a little more on the cheeks so I can really get a good feel for it. You can see that the glow is still coming through. And underneath my eyes, it did not get cakey by putting a little bit of the powder over. So I will say that the powder, see now where I didn't put a lot of powder, it's still very tacky, that Natasha Denona. I don't like that feel. That's a preference, my friends. That doesn't mean that this is not a good product because you can see it gave great coverage. It gave a beautiful glow. Even using powder over it, the glow is still there. So I would say that if you are interested in the Natasha Denona, I think that the primer is a very important part of it. And I also feel that you will have to find a powder that isn't going to mattify it. That's very important because there's no sense going into this type of foundation that is meant to give you a beautiful glow and then mattifying it. Now, I don't like a glow in my T-zone, so I don't mind doing that. But as we age, we all want a little more glow, and you can see that there is a beautiful glow. Now, the concealer, I feel, is I'm going to have to use a corrector under it for it to work for me, but I will do that in another makeup application, and I will see if it works for me that way. But the powder is definitely staying, and I may keep the Natasha Denona now. So if you're using any of these products, the Natasha Denona, tell us what powder you're using over it, or perhaps you're somebody who likes that just complete glow on your face, and you're using cream blushes and all cream products with it. So share in the comments if you are using the Natasha Denona primer and foundation, and my contact is dancing around in my eye. I think it's trying to pop out. And also, if you're using the concealer, if you have a lot of lines underneath your eyes, are your eyes more oily versus dry? How does it hold up throughout the day? And for all of you warm weathered people, please share with me how it holds up for you in the warm weather, because I'm in cold weather right now. I've not used any of these in Florida, so it will be interesting to see, because the humidity levels are very different, as you all know. And I will say, first impression, this powder is really beautiful. I mean, for an aging woman especially, this powder is just, it's gorgeous. It is better than the Laura Mercier translucent powder. And you know, I have had, a lot of people think I just bought this by Terry Hydra powder. I've had this powder a very long time. Joelle sent this to me, maybe almost 2 years ago. And I use it a lot. It's very, very similar to me, to the Makeup Forever, but it's not really a translucent powder as far as I'm concerned, and I don't like it under my eyes because I have a lot of wrinkles. So if you're someone who's younger without wrinkles, then you can set your under eye makeup, because many of you are asking me, how do I like it under my eyes? I don't wear it under my eyes because I have lines underneath my eyes. So it'll be interesting to see how this powder holds up, because no powder has been perfection underneath my eyes, none. But I will tell you, I'm thinking I may be keeping the little system because of the powder. It really it's just a preference. If you don't mind a little tackiness and that glow all over, even in your T-zone, you're going to love this foundation and primer, okay? And, you know, who knows? Maybe they'll end up in my favorites at some point. All right, thanks for stopping by. Don't forget, subscribe. We're anti-aging here. Be happy, healthy, beautiful, and most of all, my friends, lovable. Because, you know, I love you all. Bisous.